Good morning, good morning, good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
And good morning, Facebook. All those, usually I see a number up there. I don't see that number today. But I did get on early this morning and asked all of you to go to the Living Bread Church of Grace and Hope web Facebook page. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
So that's where we're going to be starting to do our Facebook from, is the web, is the Facebook page. So go on, join, and our coordinator for the Facebook page, he will get your friend request and acknowledge it so that you can be on. Amen. To God be glory. This morning, we're going to do communion. And after we do communion, we'll be leaving, and then my sister in Christ, Reverend Ben Newkirk, will continue with the service. Amen. She will continue with the service. Amen.
Amen.
God be the glory. Thanks so much. We're going to have our prayer now with our brother Jackson Jordan, followed by our communion scripture. So any of you who would like to take communion with us this morning, I know this is the first thing. Get your juice, your water, your wine, whatever you choose to have. Then get your bread, because we're going to be doing that this morning.
Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, for waking us all up this morning and allowing us to see a new day. We thank you, Lord, for just for being you, for coming. We're getting close to the season of your death and resurrection. And we just thank you again, also for just doing that for us.
Thank you.
We know that we wouldn't have been able to do anything. We can't do anything without you, Lord. And we just continue to thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Lord, we ask you to watch over the service this morning. We ask you to watch over us as we do communion. We ask you to just continue to bless our church, bless
Lord,
our pastor,
Lord Jesus.
Bless the speaker for the hour this morning.
Thanks, Lord.
And Lord, we ask you also to watch out for us as we prepare to leave and travel over to the Holy Land this morning.
Yes,
Lord. We ask you to look out for us while we're gone and get us back safely.
Yes,
Lord,
yes.
We continue to ask you to bless our community,
Lord.
St. James Church and their pastor.
Yes.
We ask the Lord to continue to look out for our country,
yes.
All of our military, all of our workers. Just continue, Lord. We know that things will seem like they're out of control, but we know, Lord, that in the end, you are in control.
Yes.
And
yes.
We just continue to ask you to take care of us all.
Yes.
This is my prayer this morning in Jesus' name. Amen.
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 Good morning, church.
Good morning.
The scripture is one of the first Corinthians 23:34. For I pass on to you what I received from the Lord himself. On that night when he was betrayed, the Lord Jesus took some bread, gave thanks to God for it. Then he broke it into pieces and said, "This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, he took a cup of wine after supper, saying, "This cup is a new covenant between God and his people, an agreement confirmed with my blood. Do this in remembrance of me as often as you drink it." For every time you eat this bread and drink this cup, you are announcing the Lord's death until he comes again.
Yes.
So anyone who eats this bread and drinks this cup of the Lord unworthily is guilty of sinning against the body and the blood of the Lord. That is why you should examine yourself before eating the bread and drinking the cup. For if you eat the bread, drink the cup without owning the body of Christ, you are eating and drinking God's judgment upon yourself. That is why many of you are weak, sick, and some have even died. But if we would examine ourselves, we would not be judged by God in this way. Yet when we are judged by the Lord, we are just being disciplined, so we would not be condemned along with the world. So my dear brothers and sisters, when you gather for the Lord's Supper, wait for each other. If you are really hungry, eat at home, so you won't bring judgment upon yourself when you meet together. I'll give you instruction about other matter after I arrive. Amen.
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 Amen. To God be the glory, and let us prepare now for communion. I thank the Lord for representing Newkirk. Amen. This is early for her. Amen. We have to get up and drive down, but we thank God that she does that. And I've learned a long time ago from a Reverend Roosevelt Holmes. He always said, it's a shared ministry. Mm-hmm. If you don't have shared your ministry,
then you
go back to the drawing
Amen.
Board.
Amen. Amen.
It's a shared ministry. Amen. And I thank God that I can share that with her, that early in the mornings, no matter if she can't get here, if something break down or whatever, she to God be the glory. She does. Let us prepare now for our communion. Amen. For the Holy Communion. Amen. To God be the glory. To God be the glory. As the scripture has already been read. As the scripture has already been read and lifted up. Our dear Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you. We thank you for these elements.
Yes.
In representation of your body and your blood.
Yes.
Thank you, God. We're in the Lent season. So thank you, God.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, God, for sending your son. Thank you, Jesus, for coming through flesh, mm-hmm. Lord, to see how it really feels to know everything about us physically in the flesh. But God, you showed us one thing, that even in the flesh, we need to sacrifice it, and we need to do your will.
Yes.
So God, we thank you.
Thank you.
And we give you glory, Lord Jesus. The body, Lord, we bless it in your name.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. The blood, Lord, we bless it in your name.
Yes.
And Lord, those who partake of it, our Facebook, our members here, Lord, bring healing to their bodies. Bring healing to their situations.
Yes.
Oh, Heavenly Father, we thank you. We thank you this morning. We thank you. We thank you. In Jesus' name, amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Praise God. The body of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Break it and eat all of it with thanksgiving. His body broken just for you. The blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Drinking all of it and thanking him for all that he did on the cross. Amen. Now let us repeat the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses
as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever. Amen.
Amen. Well, as you know, usually there is a benediction, but not this morning. Amen.
Amen.
We're going to continue with the service. Amen. Reverend Newkirk, come on up. Amen. To God be the glory. And thank you all. Thank you all this morning for participating and joining us in our community service. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. And then we're going to have Sister Crystal Galloway will be coming with the daily bread. Brother
Rashawn.
He'll be gone. Brother Jackson Jordan the third will be coming with the announcements. Amen. Amen. And then Reverend Kirk.
Amen.
Okay, to God be the glory. And if anyone can come up with a black instrument, y'all are welcome to come up and do that.
Digiti mini, and the contraction only appears when someone lifts their pinky. Michelangelo, known as a master of intricate details, paid close attention to the human bodies he sculpted, and intimate features most everyone else would miss. Michelangelo knew the human body in ways few other sculptors had. But the details he carved into granite were his attempts to reveal something deeper. The soul, the interior life of human beings. And of course, there Michelangelo always fell short. Only God knows the deepest realities of human heart. Whatever we see of one another, no matter how attentive or insightful it might be, is only a shadow of the truth. But God sees deeper than the shadows. You know me, Lord, the prophet Jeremiah said, you see me. God's knowledge of us isn't theoretical or cerebral. He doesn't observe us from a distance. Rather, he peers into the hidden realities of who we are. God knows the depths of our interior lives, even those things we struggle to understand ourselves. No matter how our struggles or what's going on in our hearts, God sees us and truly knows us. What makes you feel alone, isolated, or unseen? How does it change things to realize that God knows you? Dear God, this world can be a lonely place, but I'm astounded at how truly you know me. It fills me with wonder and joy.
Amen.
Neighbors Help the Neighbors will be Saturday, March 25th at noon here at the Community Center. Our sick and shut-in list is Trinity Walton, Nora Crawford, Rhonda Richmond, Carol Lewis, Pastor Ron Davis, Lori Corbian, Lucille Burrow family, Edith Foy family, and Charles Newkirk, and our prison ministry adoptees of Ryan Brown and Taekwondo.
Amen. Touch me, touch those that are listening.
Yes.
In the
precious name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, we do make this prayer.
Yes.
It's a privilege and a real pleasure to stand before you this morning with the word that God has implanted in me. Simple, simple word. And my subject is excuses, excuses, excuses. And we go to the Bible in Luke 9. That's Luke 9, and it starts at the 57th verse and goes down to the 61st verse. Luke 9, 57 through 62. And it reads, "Now it happened as they journeyed on the road that someone said to him, 'Lord, I will follow you wherever you go.' And Jesus said to him, 'Foxes have holes and birds of the air have nests, but the Son of Man has nowhere to lay his head.' Then he said to another, 'Follow me.' But he said, 'Lord, let me first go and bury my father.' Jesus said to him, 'Let the dead bury their own, but you go and preach the kingdom of God.' And another said, 'Lord, I will follow you, but let me first go and bid them farewell who are at my house.' But Jesus said to him, 'No one having put his hand to the plow and looking back is fit for the kingdom of God.'" Excuses, excuses that were made. First, we look at the first one, he was the impulsive disciple. It seems that one of his followers got carried away with all the miracles and the excitement that was going on with Jesus' ministry. And he said, "I'll follow you. I'll go wherever you go, Jesus. I'm ready to go." And Jesus let him know, "Foxes have holes and birds have nests, but the Son of Man has nowhere to lay his head." Jesus was simply letting him know, don't let your enthusiasm blur the cost of being a disciple. Jesus knew if this man followed him, when times got rough, when the emotional highs were way off, the commitment would fizzle down, and he would not be a disciple. See, Christ didn't use gimmicks and he didn't to gain his followers. He simply laid down some tough demands. The person that finds the greatest joy in calling our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ is the one who has counted the cost.
Yes.
And says, "Lord, I will follow you."
Mama.
You see, excuses, excuses. Then we got the reluctant disciple. Some of us are like that. Jesus said to another man, "Follow me." And he said, "Suffer me first to go bury my father." He wanted to follow Jesus. He wanted to make a commitment. But he had some reservations. And he wanted to delay going. Obviously, his father had not already died. Or he would not have been there. He would have been home making arrangements for taking care of a funeral. His father was probably old and he was probably feeble. And he was going to want to go home and wait. None of us know when we're going to take our last breath.
Amen, amen.
And then he felt like he would be free to follow. That's some of us. We want to put this aside, that aside, then we want to follow. Come on and follow the Master.
Yes,
see, we
yes.
can't clean ourselves up, but he can. If we reach our hands out to him and say, "Here we are. Here I am, Lord, just as I am, without one plea," he wraps us in his arm and he begins to take the scales off of us. Yes, when we think about the man turned down a non-discipleship to follow Jesus, means to make a commitment of your life now, that you follow him without waiting to take care of this, that, and the other thing, as people can say. Jesus doesn't want you to discredit your family ties. He's simply saying, get your eyes off of past ties, past problems, future worries. The man was saying, "Suffer me first." But Jesus said, "Seek me first. Give me first place in your life."
Yes.
And if we give him first place in our lives, look what he can do. The bargain disciples. You know, some of us want to make a bargain. Yeah. Now and then.
Mama.
That was the main. The man is sort of like a reluctant disciple in a sense to speak. He wanted to be with Jesus. He wanted to be a disciple.
Yes.
He wanted to be there, but there's that big word, spell a little, but. But there was a difference when he said, "Follow me, Peter and Andrew." The Bible says that straightway they left their nets and followed Jesus. James and John immediately left the ship and they followed him. Remember Levi sitting at the receipt of customs? He left all and rose up and followed Jesus. In Matthew 20 and 22, Luke 5 and 28 tells us that story. So that's how we are. We got to move. We get from being complacent.
Yes.
We got to follow.
Yes.
Wherever he tells us to go, whatever he tells us to do,
must
be willing to do it.
Yes.
You see, he's our all in all.
Yes, he is.
And man cannot give us life eternal.
Mm.
Did they understand everything? No, we can never understand everything. We would not understand the whole Bible. But we can ask him for guidance. We can ask him for understanding. Nobody knows it all.
That's right.
And no one is perfect. We are all shading scales as we walk along this highway of life.
Amen.
They weren't versed in theology. Of course not. You know, we got a lot of reverend doctors.
Yes.
But they still don't know everything.
Say so, say
Did
so.
Did they fully understand the plan of salvation? Did they understand how to operate in the word of God with their faith yet? No. They understood one thing, a willingness to leave everything else behind and to follow Jesus at once. And that's how we are. We will never understand everything, but we can follow him and learn as we go. Let me go back. But Jesus knew if he went back, what would he do? He probably would stay there. So he said to him, no man, having put his hands to the plow and looking back, is fit for the kingdom of God. Discipleship means decisive, clear action, which cuts us off from those things which may be attempting to pull us back. We don't want to go back in bondage. We don't want to be entangled in sin. So therefore, we give our life to Christ, and he begins to clean us, and he begins to show us things. He begins to guide us. He begins to direct us in the way that he would have us to go. Once we give our life to Christ, he begins to work with inside.
Yes,
to
us,
and it comes on the outside. There's a light shining that others need to see. There are others that are lost in the world. But we as Christians, if we let our light shine so that they can see that Christ in us, we got to stop condemning. We got to stop pointing the finger. We've got to stop doing those things. Because when we do those things, people go further and further away from the Master.
Yes.
They want no part. So in the house of the Lord, we need to show more love, more compassion, and more concern. That's what we need to do for Lent. Instead of the meat and the sodas and the sugar, which I love desserts, we got, that's not everything. We got to put some other stuff away and show that we care about God's people. Because we are his mouth, we are his hands, we are his eyes, and we are his ears.
Yes.
And if we do what he's directed us to do, we can bring others into the house.
Yes.
God bless you. That's my word for today. No more excuses.
Mama.
We must step up to the plate.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Thank you, God, for your word.
Thank you, Father.
Bless these, your people, Father. The listening ears that hear this morning.
Yes.
Let them do what God has asked them to do.
Yes.
They are your hands.
Yes, God.
They are your feet.
Yes.
They are your ears and they are your eyes. So God, work within them and let them know. They can never get it completely right before
Jesus.
They step up to the plate. But step up to the plate now and follow him.
Yes.
No more excuses. It's time. It's winding down.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Everyone that enjoyed the service today. Thank you, Reverend Newkirk, for filling in. Next Sunday, we will be back. I'm not sure who's preaching yet.
Let me
Facebook page, that's where service will be. Everyone have a good Sunday. Enjoy the rest of your day.